Good morning student, welcome back in the next video of bio. Students, in the previous video I have taught you about the different parts of flower and types of flowers. Today again I am going to demonstrate the different part of a flower. So you have already studied that flower has four whorls. The outermost whorl is known as the sepal. It is a leaf like structure which is generally green in color, and the main function of the sepal is to protect the flower bud before it opens. The second whorl is known as the petal. Petals may be of different size, color and shapes, but mostly they are the second whorls, and the main work of the petal is to attract different types of birds or insect toward them, and feathers which help them to help in the process of pollination. The third part of whorl, or the third oral, is known as the stamen, which is also known as the male part, and it consists of filament and anther. Filament, you can see this small structure is known as a filament. These are the fibrous structures, and the uppermost part is known as the anther. Anthers are bilobed, means they have two lobes, and these anther consist of the pollen grains. When you touch them, you can find very fine particles or dusty particles known as the pollen grain. And the innermost part is known as the female part or the carpel. The carpel consists of three parts known as stigma, style and ovary. So student, the female part or carpel consists of three parts, stigma, style and ovary. The pollen grains from the anthers reach to the stigma, means stigma are the recipient of the pollen grains. From there, pollen grains goes down through the style and reach the ovary. Ovary is the swollen part and it consists of one or more ovules. So these are the four whorls of a flower, and mostly a complete flower has these four parts in them. And flowers are already distributed into two types, bisexual or the unisexual.